Hello dear students, today I will be continuing with the third edition of Act 3, Scene 2. So till now we have read that Bassanio has been successful in winning Portia. He has chosen the right casket and both are very happy at this choice because both wanted to marry each other. Now at this time, when they are about to get married, when their marriage ceremony is going to be solemnized, Nerissa and Grishanio surprise them with their decision. Grishanio informs Bassanio that the moment they entered Belmont and the moment he saw Nerissa, he fell in love with her and tried to persuade her to marry him. But Nerissa had declined so far. And after much persuasion, Nerissa promised that she would marry Grishanio only if Bassanio wins the right casket. And since now Bassanio has won the right casket, he has been successful to get married to Portia, so Nerissa will also agree to get married to Grishanio. So we will be starting from this point. I will be starting with Grishanio's dialogue, line number 200. Grishanio, I thank your lordship. You have gone me one. You have got me one. Got me one? You have got me a wife. My eyes, my lord, can look as swift as yours. Swift, quick. I was also quick to find Nerissa. You saw the mistress, I beheld the maid, beheld, saw. You loved, I loved, for intermission, delay. Now, what was the purpose of my delay? No more pertains to me, my lord, than you. He says, I am also very quick in taking decisions, just as you are. Your future stood upon the caskets there, stood upon, depended. And so did mine too. So he says, I never neglect any opportunity just like you. See this line again. I loved for intermission no more pertains to me, my lord, than you. So he says, I never miss any opportunity just like you. I grabbed the opportunity. I saw Nerissa and I proposed her. For wooing her until I sweat again and swearing till my very roof was dry, roof, tongue. He said, I kept on proposing her, persuading her till my tongue also dried, but she did not confirm. With oaths of love at last, if promise last, I got a promise of this fair one here. This fair one stands for Nerissa. He says, at last Nerissa said yes, but on what condition? I got a promise of this fair one here to have her love, provided that your fortune achieved her mistress. She said, only if Bassanio wins over Portia. Now Portia is also surprised. She says, is that true, Nerissa? And Nerissa confirms. So Bassanio says, I am more than happy that if you also get married over here along with us. And do you, Grishanio, mean good faith? Good faith, are you really sincere in your love? Yes, faith, my lord. Our fee shall be much honored in your marriage. Feast means wedding. So it was decided that both the couples are going to get married over there. But at that very moment, when this was going to happen, somebody entered. Who are they? But who comes here? Lorenzo and his infidel. Infidel, non-believer, non-Christian. She was a Jew. However, she has turned into a Christian now otherwise because she has married a Christian man. What, and my Venetian friend, Salerio. So, Salerio enters along with Jessica and Lorenzo. Bassanio, Lorenzo and Salerio, welcome hither, hither, here. If that the youth of my new interest here have power to bid you welcome. If that the youth of my interest, my recently got title. So Bassanio is looking towards Portia and saying, if I have the right to invite my friends, because I have newly acquired these rights of being a husband of Portia, being the owner of the big palace. By your leave, I bid my very friends and countrymen, sweet Portia, welcome. So he says to Portia that I would like to welcome my friends at this place. So do I, my lord. They are entirely welcome, entirely, heartily. Lorenzo, I thank your honor. For my part, my lord, my purpose was not to have seen you here, meet here. So Lorenzo clarifies the moment he meets Bassanio that he was not interested to come here to Portia's place. He says, but there was a very serious matter, and so Salerio forced us to come along at Belmont. My purpose was not to have seen you here, but meeting with Salerio, by the way, he did entreat, request me, past all saying no, in spite of saying no. Lorenzo says, I refuse Salerio, that I don't want to go and disturb Bassanio anyway. But Salerio forced me to come along. And then Salerio confirms. So Salerio and Salerino are the same. I hope you know there are two characters, Salenio and Salerino. In some books they have given another name for Salerino, that is Salerio. I did, my lord, and I have reason for it. Signor Antonio commends him to you. Salerio says, yes, I have brought Lorenzo, and I have some news also to give you. And before I give you the news, Antonio has sent you his greetings. Commends him to you. He is greeting you. He has sent his greetings to you. Bassanio, ere I open his letter, ere, before, ope is open. I pray you tell me how my good friend does. How is he? He says, okay, if he has sent me a letter, I will read the letter. But before I open this letter, you tell me, how is my friend Antonio? Salerio, not sick, my lord, unless it is mine, emotional and mental sickness. He says he is perfectly healthy physically, but mentally he is very upset. Nor well unless in mind. Nor he is well in the state of his. So he says physically he is perfect, but he is having lot of mental pressure right now. And then Bassanio reads the letter. So by the time Bassanio is reading the letter, Gratiano realizes that Jessica is standing towards the other side, and she is the only female standing that side. So Gratiano, being the husband of Nerissa now, he asks his wife Nerissa to go and greet Jessica as she is the guest over here. Nerissa, cheer your stranger. Stranger over them stands for Jessica. Bid her welcome. Your hand, Salerio, what is the news from Venice? So meanwhile, when Nerissa greets Jessica, Gratiano talks to Salerio. How doth that royal merchant, good Antonio? I know he will be glad of our success. We are the Jasons. We have won the fleece. So you remember fleece, the wool. You remember Act 1, Scene 1 itself, when Bassanio talks about Portia to Antonio. There we read about the story of the island of Colchos, where Jason ultimately killed the dragon and he won over the treasure of the island of Colchos, and he also married Medea. You remember? So here Gratiano refers to that. He says, we are the Jasons. We have also won what? Our true love. Bassanio has won over Portia and I have won over Nerissa. And obviously when Bassanio has won over Portia, he has also won lot of wealth of Portia. Salerio, I would wish you had won the fleece that he had lost. So Salerio says, I wish that the money which Bassanio has won now, which Bassanio has acquired now after marrying Portia, if that money could help Antonio to come out of the clutches of Shylock. Because Salerio knows that Shylock is not going to leave Antonio. Portia, there are some shrewd contents in your shrewd contents bad news in yours in yon some paper. Yon some paper, in that paper. Paper here stands for the letter. So the moment Bassanio reads the letter, Bassanio goes completely pale. उसके चेहरे का रंग ही उड़ गया. He is surprised what has happened. So Portia has seen that changing face of Bassanio, and so she comments, what happened? There might be some bad news that you have gone completely pale. That steals the color from Bassanio's cheek. Some dear friend dead? Else nothing in the world could turn so much the constitution of any constant man. Constitution and emotional state. So she, Portia thinks that maybe some Bassanio's, some friend has died. And he has got that news. That is why he is feeling so pale and dumbfounded. But the reality is something else. What worse and worse with leave Bassanio? I am half yourself, and I must freely have the half of anything that this paper brings you. So Portia says to Bassanio that I am your wife now. So I am half yours. So I should get all the news which you have with you. Tell me what has been written in this letter which has shocked you so much. Bassanio, oh sweet Portia, here are few of the unpleasantest words that ever blotted paper. That ever blotted paper that have been written on paper. So now in this dialogue, Bassanio tells Portia the reality. He says, when I came to you for the first time when Portia's father was also alive, I had told you that I am a noble man, but I have nothing. He said, I never told you lie. I told you that time also that I have nothing, but I never described that word nothing. He said, I had told you I am a noble man. No doubt I am a noble man. Noble blood runs in my veins. But nothing was not explained, and nothing exactly meant that I really had nothing. At that time, I did not tell you that I was under debt. Maine karza liya hua hai. So today I am going to tell you that I was under debt, and my friend Antonio signed a very risky and dangerous bond just to furnish me with 3,000 ducats. And he tried and he risked his life to Shylock, his most bitterest enemy. So he's telling all this. Gentle lady, when I did first impart my love to you, express my love to you, when was that first attempt? When Bassanio had come, which we read in Act 1, Scene 2, when Nerissa and Portia were talking. At that time, we read about it, but Bassanio had already visited this place when the father was alive, father of Portia. When I did first impart my love to you, I freely told you all the wealth I had ran in my veins. I freely, frankly told you, ran in my veins, that I belonged to a noble family. I was a gentleman, and then I told you true. And yet, dear lady, rating myself at nothing, you shall see how much I was a brigand. Brigand, boastful. Maine us time bhi bahut badha chadha ke bola, because I didn't tell you what nothing meant for me. When I told you my state was nothing, state, my wealth was nothing, I should then have told you that I was worse than nothing. At that time, I should have told you that even nothing word is very less for me, because I was entirely zero, not at all anything. I have engaged myself to a dear friend, pledged myself to a dear friend. Who is a dear friend? Antonio. Engaged my friend to his mere enemy, mere bitter. To feed my means, to manage money for myself. Here is a letter, lady, the paper as the body of my friend, and every word in it a gaping wound, gaping open wound, issuing life blood. Issuing, jutting out blood. So she says, this letter which I am holding, this letter is just like the body of Antonio. And every word written on the letter इज जस्ट लाइक एन ओपन वूंड, खुला हुआ जख्म जो दिखाई दे रहा है. दीज आर नॉट द वर्डिंग्स ऑफ द लेटर, मुझे ऐसे लग रहा है दिस इज द वूंड्स ऑफ एंटोनियो. एंड और वूंड्स में से क्या निकल रहा है, द ब्लड इज ऊजिंग आउट. बट इज इट ट्रू सेलेरियो, हैथ ऑल हिज वेंचर्स फेल्ड, वेंचर्स शिप्स. ही इज कंफर्मिंग फ्रॉम सेलेरियो दैट वाकई इट हैज हैपेंड लाइक दिस, नो शिप हैज रिटर्न्ड. सिक्स शिप्स हैड बीन मेंशन्ड बाय शाइलॉक. व्हाट, नन हिट, नन हिट रिटर्न्ड बैक सेफ फ्रॉम त्रिपोलीज, मेक्सिको, इंग्लैंड, लिस्बन, बारबरी एंड इंडिया. रिमेंबर दीज प्लेसेस, यू हैव टू राइट द टेक्स्चुअल वर्ड्स इन योर आंसर्स. And not one vessel escaped the dreadful touch of merchant marring rocks. He says, not even one ship vessel is ship. The dreadful touch, the dangerous rocks which are present under the sea, have all the ships been hit by them? None of them came back. Not one, my lord. So Salerio confirms, he says, yes, not even a single ship has returned. Besides, it should appear that if he had the present money to discharge, to give away, to give back the Jew, he would not take it. So Salerio says, no. One, two ships have not come. Secondly, even if now Antonio manages to give the money, Shylock is not ready to take the money. He says he was supposed to take the money back on the exact date and time which was mentioned in the bond. A creature that did bear the shape of, never did I know a creature that did bear the shape of man. He says in this line, Salerio wants to say, I have never seen such a cruel creature in my life. He is not ready to listen to anyone. So keen and greedy to confound a man. Confound, to destroy. He has only one thing in his mind now, that he wants to destroy Antonio. He plies the Duke at morning and at night. Plies, urges. He says he goes to the Duke again and again and requests him. And doth impeach the freedom of the state. Impeach, he challenges the Duke. He, now in this dialogue, rest of the dialogue, Salerio is telling that Shylock is again and again repeatedly going to the Duke and asking him to get him justice. Now here one important question arises is, why cannot the Duke deny justice to Shylock? Duke can say, Shylock, I can't help it. You can do whatever you want to do. No, because Venice is a port city. All business transactions are done, all ships are moving through here, through this place, to different places. And Shylock is one of the foreigners, and foreigners enjoy special rights and status in Venice so that they can come here and do their business, which will be a financial contribution to Venice. Now, in case Duke denies justice to Shylock, it will be a wrong precedent for everyone. So by doing so, all the other foreigners will lose faith and they will stop coming to Venice for business, and it will amount to a huge financial loss. So the Duke has to listen to Shylock. He plies the Duke at morning and at night and doth impeach the freedom of the state. Impeach the freedom of the state, talking about the rights given to the foreigners. If they deny him justice, so he says, Shylock openly says, if justice is denied to me, that will be a wrong statement for all the foreigners. Now, it's not that nobody has gone to Shylock. 20 merchants, the Duke himself and the magnificos of greatest port. Magnificos, the noblemen. He says, till now, more than 20 businessmen, the Duke himself and the great ministers, magnificos, the noble people, the great ministers of Venice, have gone to Shylock to request him to leave Antonio. Have all persuaded with him, but none can drive him from the envious plea. But nobody has been successful in changing the decision of Shylock. He is only repeating one thing, that he wants his bond. What is the bond? that in case Antonio fails to return 3,000 ducats at the proper time and place, Shylock is free to cut 1 pound of flesh from any part of Antonio's body. Now Jessica is standing there, remember, and she is Shylock's daughter. She also confirms the same thing. She says, I know my father, and I have seen that my father had taken an oath in front of me that he is going to ruin Antonio. He is never going to forgive Antonio. When I was with him, I have heard him swear to Tubal and to cuss his countrymen. So remember a new word, cuss. Cuss means the Jew people. So Jessica says, when I used to live with him, I have heard he had sworn in front of Tubal and his Jew and the Jews people that he would rather have Antonio's flesh than 20 times the value of the sum that he did owe him. So he had said that even now somebody returns me 20 times of 3,000 ducats, 3 into 20, still he will never take the ducats back. He will only punish Antonio. And I know, my lord, if law, authority and the power deny not, stop him, it will go hard with poor Antonio. So Jessica has informed two important things. Number one, that her father had sworn in front of Tubal and Cass people that he is going to take revenge. And number two, she also warns that if no legal authority stops him, he will definitely take his revenge. Is it your dear friend that is thus in trouble? So Portia says, okay, this is all because of Antonio and Shylock's bond. The dearest friend to me, the kindest man, the best conditioned, having a very good nature, an unwearied spirit, always doing good for others without any profit. He works tirelessly for the good of humanity in doing courtesies good, and one in whom the ancient Roman honor more appears than any that draws breath in Italy. He says, we all are ancestors of Romans, and it is only Antonio who is the most noble representation of the Romans. Romans were known for their dignity, for their honesty, sincerity, kindness, helpfulness. He says all these attributes are seen in Antonio. So now Portia wants to inquire, what was the amount? So when she comes to know, it is only 3,000 ducats, and Portia is a very rich woman. And now Pisenio has married her, so all the money is of Pisenio. So what does she say? Pay him 6,000 and deface the bond. Deface, cancel. She says, only 3,000 ducats, you pay him 6,000. Double 6,000. He says, now you can double 6,000 also, 12,000. And treble that. He says, even then 12,000 can be trebled, multiplied again. So on the whole, she says that you can pay any amount of money Shylock requires. If your friend is such a good man, save him. Before a friend of this description, such a good man, shall lose a hair through Bassanio's fault, shall lose a hair, even a slightest harm can be done to him. He says, no harm should be done to Antonio just because of you. So pay him whatever he wants. First, go with me to church and call me wife. Call me wife to solemnize marriage, the marriage ceremony. They have to go to the church to call themselves husband and wife. And then away to Venice to your friend. So that shows sharp-mindedness of Portia. Portia is very smart, intelligent, witty, having great presence of mind. Immediately she takes decisions. Number one, she says, go to church. Just take 5 minutes, call me wife. Number two, immediately go to Venice and go and save your friend. Number three, take all the money and gold from me and go and save your friend. And then away to Venice to your friend, for never shall you lie by Portia's side with an unquiet soul, disturbed mind. He says, just call me wife, then run back to Venice. we will never enjoy a married life if somebody is going to suffer because of you. You shall have gold to pay the petty debt 20 times over. Petty is small. She says only 3,000 ducats. Take the gold. Pay it so many times as that man desires. When it is paid, bring your true friend along. And she says, once Antonio is free, you can bring him along with you to Belmont. Then only we will start our married life. My maid Nerissa and myself meantime will live as maids and widows. Very important point. She also tells that till you come back, I and Nerissa will lead a very simple life, like a life of a nun, like a life of a religious lady. Those people, those ladies whose husbands are not living with them, they were required to lead a very simple life. So she says, we will also be leading a simple life and praying for the welfare of all of you till you return back. For you shall hence upon your wedding day, hence go. She says, today only you will go on your wedding day. Bid your friends welcome, show a merry cheer, happy face. She says, now welcome your friends with a happy face. Since you are dear bought, I love you, dears. So she says, I have achieved you with great difficulty. So I want to keep you a happy man. But let me hear the letter of your friend. But she says, do tell me, do read out what is written in the letter. Sweet Bassanio, my ships have all miscarried. Miscarried, destroyed. My creditors grown cruel. My estate is very low. Estate, my financial position. My bond to the Jew is forfeit. So Antonio has written that my bond has been forfeited. I was unable to pay back the money. And since in paying it, it is impossible I should live. All debts are cleared between you and I. He has been very simple in writing. He says, I am ready to die. So all the transactions between you and me are clear. I am not blaming you for anything. If I might but see you at my death. But I have only one wish, that I want to see you before I die. Notwithstanding, despite this, use your pleasure. If your love do not persuade you to come, let not my letter. Love here stands for Portia. He says, I wish to see you once before I die. But in case you are too busy over there, or your lady does not want to send you, please do not come. I am not forcing you. So such a humble letter he has written. He has not even once blamed Bassanio that I'm suffering all this because of you. That shows the true, sincere, honest friendship of Antonio towards Bassanio. Oh love, dispatch all business and be gone. Dispatch, be quick. So Portia is also, she really reacted very softly when she heard this letter. She says, such a nice man. So you better just go to the church with me, come to the church, call me wife and immediately go. Since I have your good leave to go, I will make haste quickly. But till I come again, no bed shall ever be guilty of my stay. Guilty cause of my stay, delay. No rest be interposer between us twain. Interposer, stand between two of us. So Bassanio says, yes, I am running towards Venice now. But I assure you that the moment I free my friend Antonio, at that very moment I will return back to Belmont and will not stay there even for a fraction of a second after the purpose has been achieved. Because I also know that I am leaving you on my wedding day. So that was the end of this big scene. Through this scene, the casket bond has been finished. We have come to know that Portia's portrait lied in lead casket and Bassanio has won over. And a new subplot has started from this scene, that is the ring episode. And the continuation of the bond theory, which had been started in Act 1, Scene 1, which will have its climax in Act 4. We have come to know that Portia is very smart, intelligent, sharp, quick, and in many aspects she is smarter than Bassanio, which will also be proved in Act 4, that is the Court of Justice scene. So I hope you have understood it. Go through the workbook, try to solve the workbook, and we will be continuing with the next scene in the next video. Bye-bye.